Today we will be learning one of the important terms in VHDL, which you will use frequently in your system designs. I am talking about the internal signals inside the module. You can treat them like interconnection between two logical units or wires in simple terms. Till now we were talking about the signals which are in the port list inside the entity description. That means we were defining the input or the output pins of our module. But think of the wires which interconnects inside our logical design and those we wanted to use inside our functional description to connect two elements. In VHDL terms, we define them with the keyword signal, and these need to be defined inside the architecture. The main difference between the port signals which we define in the entity and another which we define in the architecture is that signals from the port list are the interface pin of your module as input or output and can be used inside the architecture associated with that entity. But the signals which we define inside the architecture are not actually the interface pins, but we wanted to use them internally, and these signals can only work inside that architecture. In VHDL, we do that by declaring the signals in the architecture between the architecture and begin statement, as I am mentioning in this example. In this example, look over the semantics where first we are doing a NAND function between input A and input B. Then we are connecting the output of NAND gate to a NOT gate, and the output of the NOT gate is our final output. Simple, right? Now look over the wire which is connecting the output of the NAND gate and input to the NOT gate. We will call this interconnection or wire, and in terms of VHDL we call this signal. Now if you notice, this signal is neither the input interface of your module nor the output interface of your module, but it is just lying inside your module. So let's declare the internal signal then. We declare the internal signal named as S and define its data type as bit. After this declaration, you can use this signal S in our architecture anywhere and can connect different parts of your function. Let's explore little our code now. Here we have some sequential statements inside the process body that if both the inputs, these are input A and input B, are equal to 1, then our internal signal S will get the value of 0. And if any input is 0, then our internal signal S will get the value of 1. Now if we have taken a note that this conditional statements act simply like a NAND gate, and our internal signal S gets a function of NAND gate. To get this function of AND gate to the output Dout, we inverted the signal S with a NOT gate, and the output of the NOT gate is our final output Dout, and this output Dout is the output of our module. So let me give a quick brief what we did here. We are designing a simple AND gate. That means output Dout will be 1 if both inputs are 1, else the output Dout will be 0. So first we define the entity which has two inputs, input A and input B, and one output Dout. Then we declared a signal inside the architecture which will act as an internal signal, and inside the process body we write the behavior of a NAND gate and move the result into our internal signal S. Now in the concurrent statement outside the process, we used the NOT gate to invert the value of our internal signal S and then move that to our final output Dout. Note that Dout is the output of our interface which we declared in the entity. So that was the basic idea of SDL, that we can describe multiple behavior and then wire them together using the internal signals. At the moment, don't be confused with the concurrent statements and sequential statements because we will be covering them later in the series. But just understand at the moment that anything which we are writing inside the process will execute sequentially, and those statements which are outside the process body will execute concurrently. Now, based on the functional description which we have written here inside the architecture for the AND gate, think about the possible inputs of A and B. What would be the value of internal signal S, and then what we will get at the output D out. So truth table for our design will be like this. When input A and B both are 1, internal signal S will be 0. And then its inverted value will be our output D out. That means 1 we will get at the output D out. Similarly, if any input is 0, then internal signal S will be 1, and hence its inverted value 0 will be the output D out. I hope you can map this simple truth table now with the functional descriptions we have written in the architecture. Now think a bit about the structure of the logical design which we may get from the synthesizer tool on these descriptions we have written here in this architecture. If you want, keep a pause here and spare some time to think before continue. Let me give a hint that the sequential statements in the process are describing a NAND gate with inputs A and B, and the computed results goes to internal signal S, and then the output of the internal signal S wired up with the NOT gate, and the output of the NOT gate is the output of our schematic, which is D out. So the schematic would be like this in terms of logical diagram, but we just written that with the text in VHDL. There can be many ways of writing the schematic in VHDL, which we will see slowly in this learning series, and you can choose which method you wanted to use for which design. This is the mixed design, where we take in place of sequential statements inside the process and concurrent statements outside the process. You could write them completely as concurrent statements or completely as sequential statements, or some other ways too. But whatever method you choose, if you write your code correctly, then your simulation results will be same and synthesized results as well. Let's quickly see the syntax in VHDL for signal. So we declare signal between the architecture statement and the begin statement. To declare a signal, write signal followed by the signal name, then press colon and write the signal type, and in the last press semicolon. There are a few important things to remember about signal. Unlike entity ports, signals are declared without directions. You can declare signal inside the architecture, but you cannot declare them inside the process, but you can use them inside the process as well. You can define as many signal as you want in your design. You can define the default value of your signal while declaration if you want. For this, after giving the signal type, write colon equals to, and then give the default value of signal, and then semicolon. You can refer the example in the screen for signal S, which is bit type, and the default value is set as 0. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like and leave a comment below, and don't forget to subscribe for regular updates.